Hi everyone, this is Wood again with a new Minecraft video. I wanted to show you what I was working on, but first I want to thank the 50 more subscribers I have on my channel right now. This is absolutely amazing. I had like less than 10 a day ago and just went on a server and helped someone. His name's Camaro, but his YouTube name I'll link in the description. And he just I just helped him made a circuit, and he passed the word to his friend and everyone joined. That's absolutely amazing. Thank you everyone. So let's celebrate. Yeehaw! Super fun. Thanks again. And now let me show you my doomsday device. No, actually it's a mob sorting, killing, gathering and looting machine, semi-automatic. Friendly mob, that is. I've got here, let me show you the working panel. I can gather cows and sheep or kill cows and sheep. Actually, now it's down, so it's on kill mode. I can kill the chickens, or I can let them live and collect eggs and feather. Well, actually just eggs, collect feathers when I kill them. I can collect the loot, the wool and leather from the cows and sheep, and the cooked pork chop from the pigs. The wolves don't get anything, but they still do get separated from the rest of the bunch, because I first intended to use them on the wool shearing machine, but since 1.7 it doesn't work anymore, so they just go to die since they have a use. So right now this is just like a draft. I want to make this on my SMP server, survival, so I'm improving on the traps and everything, but that's what I've came up with so far. So this is the working panel. Let me just show you what it does. We're gonna first start to gather cows and sheep, so I'm gonna show you that after. Let's collect the pork chop. We can see them right here. Collect the leather and the wool from right here. And let's start killing the chickens. Okay, we're gonna go a look at this. So this is the spawning pad. Not much of a spawning pad, it's just a mock-up, because anyway this is the only grass on the map, so everything spawns here. This is the chamber, the tunnel where every animal falls through, and this is where the chicken gets separated. The sign here make it so every animal falls through except the chicken, because the chicken float on the first water they find. And here it is supposed to be killing chicken, and it is not. Oh. Let me just reset the clock here. Forgot I have to fix this. I need to send the pulse like 2-3 seconds, like this. And now the chicken get killed. So if I don't want to collect to collect any eggs, I just put it on, and that's what it does. For the collection part, use the sticky piston here, just remove the glass block here, and all the feathers fall in the eggs too. I'm gonna stop the clock. I have a reset here, that's a piston that removes a block from the clock. And when I see the pulse ended, I can just I'm just, like I said, it's a draft, I'm gonna automate this a lot more. So yeah, this is my clock. Super basic. Oh yeah, so I've collected my loot. I collect even ink sack since it's the only water, or almost. Okay, now, oh yeah, the pig cooker. don't know from where this is from, but I got the idea of building this on from seeing one of Akatera's video. He has one that it's more complete than mine, but I want to make mine in my design. So the pig falls through a lava here and they die while on fire, so they drop cooked pork chop. And I use the same trap for the wolves and the cows and sheep. So now we have the cows and sheep on gather mode, so I've made the junction here. I've seen on one of Dawkins' video it using pistons, so when it's on gather, this one's open and this one's closed, so the water stream goes this way on this canal elevator that raise them so they can get fall damage. And when it's on kill mode, this one's open, this one's closed, and they just fall through the lava. And this I made based of one of Ito's video. I like the idea at first, but using it I don't like it really much. First, like this animal can fall in the same hole, so I would use this to collect milk with buckets from cows and dye sheep, so I can have more colored wool easily, even though wool is now easily made if you have a spider farm. But yeah, that's basically all it is. And I make the animals go that high so I can just, when I'm finished with them, just get him on the lumber. So they all die easily like that. So when I'm done with the wool I want and everything, just set it on kill. But the thing is, I have to collect everything manually. There's no way I can get cooked pork chop from my setup like automatic go on the plate here, because the pigs need to die on fire so they can't fall on the water below, otherwise they won't die and they just get out of the machine alive. That's not really what I want. So that's it. If you have any ideas on how I can improve, please feel free to tell. Like I said, this is just a draft. I'm gonna have something more elaborate done in my SMP world, and when it's done, I'm gonna do another video about it. So thanks for watching. Goodbye. I also forgot to mention, I got distracted by the chicken not getting killed. The rest of the sorting machine, after the mobs fall in this chamber, after getting separated from the chicken, the tall mob gets separated from the small one. So in front of me here, there's a 2-high, 1-wide canal, so the cows and sheep go through them. There's a source block here, so the current is going diagonally, and here is only a 1-high and 2-wide, but that doesn't really matter. The important thing is it's 1-wide and the current is going this way, so the pigs and wolf get tossed this way while the cows and sheep follow this line. I don't have any way to separate cows and sheep yet. I've tested with some things, I've tried experiment, but nothing seemed to separate those two, so for now it's just that. And the pig and wolf separator is only a ladder here. The pig won't fall through the ladder, so they get on this stream, but the wolves, they fall through and they get in that stream. That's the sorting mechanism. And I said I didn't like this idea. I like the idea of having the animal under here, and I can kill them in one blow. But what I don't like is that they can be 2 or 3 or 4 animals in the same spot. So I want to try something like adding all the way here that would separate every animal individually. So they would go through here, but it would take a while, but I don't really care. They have to walk, so it will be kind of random when they get in each chamber. So the first animal would go here, cannot pass through. There would be a second piston on top, but just a mock-up. And when they activate this plate, the piston behind them closes, so they can't get back. And the piston here retracts, and this one's open. So now the second animal can come in this chamber. And now after that, the third goes in the last. This one resetted, and this one closed. But it would go on more than that. I want to like have maybe 15 chamber, 16, something like that. I don't know what's the maximum animal. I think it's 16, maybe a little more. So that would be like a 4x4 pad with every animal, one animal in every hole. That's what the goal is with that. But for now, it's not really working as I want. It's kind of a mock-up and to get a basic idea of what I want. But yeah, if you have ideas of how this can be improved, that would be a great help. So that is really it now. Thank you very much. Thanks for the subscribers again. Hope I'll have more, and I will give you more videos, that's for sure. So keep the comment. Thank you.